Hi guys, welcome back. So let's talk about API keys. Like, why do we need API keys? Where can we create them, or how can we create them, right? There are lots of questions, like how can I use an API call or something to get the details about my APIs? How can we monitor them, etc., etc.? So let's address them one step, one question at a time. Why do we need API keys, right? Let's say you are dealing with multiple projects, which involves multiple AI models. So it's basically hard to kind of monitor and track the usage of credits, right? So some of the projects may consume a lot of credits, and some of them may consume very less credits. You never know if you're using one API key for all the projects, right? But if you use separate API keys for each and every project, it looks organized and it will help you to track your own credits usage, credits consumption. And apart from that, multiple products can also use this apart from projects. So there are lots of advantages, right? And you can actually monitor all of these by filtering your API keys, filtering by the models, etc., etc. So we'll discuss all of these in this current tutorial. So without any further delay, let's get started. So now head out to the Eden AI platform and then navigate to the API keys section, right? And then you can see a specific page dedicated to all the API settings, right? And in the settings, under the feature settings, you can see there's a region which is default to the world, but you can change it to your country of preference where you want to get your data to be processed. And then there's something called save my requests, right? It's a kind of history where there's a dedicated history tab available. If you enable it, you can see your history there. And cache responses is nothing but it's a temporary history which lasts for like 5 minutes. That's why it's called cache, right? But here comes the best part. There is something called API keys, right? And the API token is available. This is the default token. You can use it for all the projects, right? So you can copy the token, you can refresh the key, you can get a new one, and you can see or you can hide the key, right? But here you can see there's something called additional API keys, right? So let's say you have multiple projects and you don't want to use the same key for all the projects. And sometimes you may have to share the key with your fellow colleagues, right? Or your teammates. So in that specific scenarios, it's always ideal to use additional API keys. So here I created an additional API key with the name test2. That's the project name for now. So I have a project called test something, and I created the name as test2. And I have a key provided here. The type is production. That's what I have given. And the balance is 10. What does it mean? So if you can see, I have 49.8 credits left. But out of that, I can only utilize 10 USD, which is the balance USD, right? The 10 USD for this project. Once I run out of 10 USD, this API keys no longer have the capability to be used, right? And we can also provide an expiry date, and which I haven't provided, right? So let's try to create a new one, create an API key, and I'll probably try it as test. The one is missing. And I want to give it 20. And expiry date, it's optional, so it's up to you. Only probably the next day. The expiry date is on Valentine's Day. And then it's the key type is production. You can make it to sandbox and create it. That's it, done. So you can see test one with the key dedicated, and then sandbox type 20. So that's it. That's how you can create a new API key for your projects, and you can use this specific key instead of the API base key, right? And when you go to the monitoring section here, so this is where you can see a dashboard of the available tokens, the usage of your tokens on specific models. So this is quite interesting, and it's insightful as well. So you can select one of the models. For example, if I select Google, right? And if I select the base token, you can see I have used 0.03 USD of base token for especially for Google provider, right? So you can choose your own tokens here and the providers and the technology as well. And there are a lot of filters, right? Even the dates from and to and the workflows to just monitor your the cost and usage of your tokens and your work. So this is pretty much straightforward of how you can do this on platform. But how can we do it using an API call? That's a question. Let's find it out. There are 5 API calls for 5 different actions. Right? So you can list down all the tokens. You can see how many tokens are there in your account. And then you can create a new token using another endpoint. And then you can retrieve the existing ones, which means if you have a token, if you want to know more details about one particular token, you can use an endpoint for that. And then you can update a token, existing ones. You can update it, change the balance, modify the expiry date. And then finally, you can also delete the token, right? So these are the 5 actions you can do using API calls. So let's see how you can do it. Right? So for the ease of our understanding, they have given us with the code snippet here. For now, I'm just looking at Python, Python-based environment, but still you can select your own environment. For example, if you are working with Node.js, so Node.js environment, you have a code snippet here, which you can use it. And then Ruby, PHP. So yeah, so for now, let's stick on to the Python. And this is the code snippet you can use directly into your projects to just retrieve the list of tokens, right? So if I just try it here. Okay, yeah. So I got like 2 tokens, right? I have 2 tokens in my account. So this is the list tokens API call, which is a get API call, of course. And then let's see how the create new token works, right? So create new token is a post endpoint. So you need to provide with a body. So you can create a new token by providing it with a name. Let's say test3, that's the name I want to give. And then token type, let's select the API token. And then balance, let me just give 14. Expiry time, I'll just give it null. I don't want any expiry time, but make sure this is in a daytime format. And then active balance, yes, I want to use the balance field, so I want to select it as true, right? And then so whenever you're modifying it, you can see the payload is getting updated simultaneously, right, parallelly. So if you just try it, see, a new token has been created. You can quickly, if you go to the UI, you can just check it from there, if it's updated or not, which it is. So yeah. And then there's something called retrieve token, right? So you just have to provide the existing token name so that you can get the details about that token, right? So I want to see about test2, and then let me try this. Yeah, it works. Test2. Have a balance of 10, and yeah, everything's good. And finally, update token, right? So I want to update my test2 with the balance of probably, I'll just give it 2 USD. Active balance, yeah, true. And that's it. Let me try. Yeah, it worked. So now the balance is 2 instead of 10, right? And finally, we can delete a token. Just type the name. Let me delete test3. I don't want test3, so I just want to delete it. You can try it. Okay. Oh yeah, sorry. It's got deleted. So no token matches with the given value. That means it's already deleted, it's not there in the TP, right? So we can quickly check if it worked or not. Let's go to the list tokens and just try. Yep, it's got deleted. We have only test1 and test2. So that's how you can try the API through the documentation provided. But how can we use it in a project? I mean, how can we test it using Postman, right? Let's check it out. Okay, so this is a simple, fast API-based backend code where I just wanted you guys to understand how the API call works, right? So, I mean, I created five methods here. All of them are as we have discussed before. So this one get all the tokens information, and then this method creates a token, right? And then this method basically it gets the particular token information, right? And then this method updates the existing token if you have any, and finally this method deletes the token, right? So I have added all the methods, and then I've created a small miniature server, and it's up and running now, right? So it's up and running in my local host. So let me check with the Postman here. Okay, so this is the first request where it should return all the existing tokens, right? And then if I hit send, yeah, you can see test one and test two. It's working perfectly. We got all the balance, active balance, and expiry time, etc. So this is working perfectly fine. And then we can try with the create a token, right? I want to create a token from here. So let me try with test three, which I've deleted before. And balance as 10. Okay. Let me just keep everything like this and then just send. Yeah, it's created. So we can just go ahead and see if it's true or not. We'll just hit it. See, we have a new API key. It is test three. Yeah. And then if you want to know more information about particular tests, so we just test three. For now, I want to test three, right? And just hit send. There you go. You got all the details for test three, right? And I made a mistake. I want to update the test three's balance to 20, right? So here I can patch, right? I can do this. And then in the, okay, it's test three, sorry. And then I want to change the balance to 21, right? Hit send. Oh, cool. Let me check it again. I want to see. Okay. See, the balance is 21. And finally, I changed my mind. I want to delete it. I don't want it. So, 3 and hit send. Yeah, token test 3 deleted successfully. And let me check it here. Yep, only we have test 1 and test. So, that's how we can implement the API calls in order to know more about the API keys we have in our project or in our account. So I hope you guys have understood everything pretty much clearly. I tried to explain it in a very naive, simple way. And if you do understood this, and if you like this video, thank you so much, and have a nice day. So I hope it's pretty clear. I kept everything straightforward and simple as possible though. Anyway, the documentation is available. If you want to have a quick look at the documentation, you can go to the EdenAI docs and you can have a look at it. But as I mentioned, I kept everything as naive as possible, so it should be pretty easy. If you guys have understood this and liked the tutorial, thank you so much. I'll see you again.